In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, today we are celebrating the fourth Sunday of Easter. And today Sunday also we call it the Sunday of the Good Shepherd. And Jesus is our shepherd and a good one. You know, if there is a good shepherd, there are also bad, shepherds. But Jesus is the good, the very good one, a good shepherd. And we are the sheep, because Jesus is the one who is guiding our steps in life. He's our leader. He's the one who is watching over us. So today, we are going to ask God for forgiveness, because sometimes we do not trust Him completely with our lives. But before asking for forgiveness, we are going to say the names of the people we are going to pray for during this Holy Mass. We are going to offer this Holy Mass for the souls of Jesus Lopez, Elena Santos, George Flores Jr., Sylvia Rivas, Shirley Ann Flores, Arthur Flores, Valerie Aguijo, Rosendo G. Martinez, Dorothy Canales, Luis G. Leal, Robert G. Leal Sr., Macrina Romero. And for the living, we are going to offer this Holy Mass for the health of Gloria Mejia, Julian Agüero, Reina Garza, Maria Estela Reyes. And also we are going to pray for those who are celebrating their birthdays and their wedding anniversary. We'll pray for Javier Chiquito, for Arlo Estrada, for Ruben Guerra. May God Himself bless them and give them more time on earth. And also, we'll pray for Ruben and Gracie Guerra for their wedding anniversary. May God bless them and keep them together as a husband and wife. And now I'm going to ask God for forgiveness, because sometimes we do not behave like a sheep. We behave like wolves or goats. That's why we ask God for forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. you take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before. Holy friends, with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. For you had gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realized what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and I will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. You may be seated. Okay, so today is the Sunday of the Good Shepherd. You know, Jesus saying, telling us today that he's a shepherd and we are the flock. We are the sheep. So why Jesus is telling us that. But let us see number one. Let us say something about the sheep. The sheep are defenseless animals. They cannot defend themselves. You know, other animals, they have claws, they have teeth, they have horns to defend themselves. But as we know, the sheep does not have the front upper teeth. So can you imagine if you don't have the front upper teeth, you cannot bite anyone. So if you open the mouth of a sheep, will you find that they are missing the front upper teeth. So they cannot defend themselves by biting someone. They cannot bite because they don't have those upper front teeth. They don't have a claws to defend themselves. They don't have horns to defend themselves. That's why they rely on a shepherd. The shepherd is the only one who can defend them. And as long as they are with the shepherd, the sheep are in peace because they know everything will be just fine. They don't worry, they are calm, they are in peace because they know that the shepherd is watching over them. They don't have to defend themselves. The shepherd will defend them. They don't have to fight against a wild animal because the shepherd will do that for them, will keep them from being attacked by wild animals. The shepherd will lead them to go eat, will guide them. So the sheep, they are really, they trust the shepherd. They listen to him, they follow him, and they know his voice. So I will say today, why don't we learn or take a lesson from the sheep, you know? Because that's what Jesus admired in the sheep, that quality they have, that trust they have toward the shepherds. And God just wants also us to have the same attitude toward him, to trust him, to let him guide our life, to let us lead us, to let him be our shepherd. So, today I see many people, you know, people worry about many things. I know that having faith in God does not keep us from difficulties. Yes, we'll go through difficulties, but if we trust God, if we believe in Him, then God will guide us, will give us guidance during difficulties. That way, we'll do things all right. God will accompany us during difficult time, and will turn our sorrows to joy if we let him do that. But I'm not saying that we should not plan, we should not, we should bury our heads in the sand. I'm not saying that. Yes, we should plan. We should plan. We should, you know, use our common sense. But at the end of the day, we have to rely on Him. We have to be able to hand over things to Him. Because sometimes the people, you know, many people today, they can't sleep at night. They can't, you know, digest the food because they worry so much, too much. You know, instead of trusting God and relying on Him. So you do what you can do as a human, and then let God do what He can do as God. Because you have things only God can do. You know, don't worry about things you cannot change. Learn to turn things over to God. It's good for you to know that this God who made you, He did not abandon you. He's watching over you. He goes wherever you go. And is there for you to help Him, is there to help you whenever you need His help. And if you want Jesus to be your shepherd, it's good for you to behave like a sheep. Because if you behave like a goat or like a wolf, you know, how can you expect Jesus to be your shepherd? You know, we are sheep, we are not wolves or goats. You know, can you imagine if you have to go to help a wolf who is wounded? Is it easy if a sheep is wounded, the sheep will let the shepherd help him. But if like a wolf is wounded, you want to help him, he's going to bite you. You know? So, if you want God to help you, be a sheep. Do not be a wolf. Let Him help you. And also today, Jesus is our shepherd. We said that. Is our shepherd, and we are His flock. And we know that Jesus also gave us some responsibilities. You know that Jesus made a church, you know. And then He said, and the head of the church He made, He put Peter in charge. And Peter was like also a shepherd. So what I mean here, we have a big shepherd, that is Jesus, and then we have also the small shepherd. And a shepherd is everyone to whom God has given a section of His flock. A shepherd is everyone to whom God has entrusted a portion of His flock. That means the Pope is a pastor because he's overlooking the church of Jesus on earth. He's a visible authority in the church of Jesus. So Jesus gave them a portion of his flock to watch over it. Because as you know, we are the hands of God. So God, you know, can you use us to bring people back to his flock. So the Pope is a shepherd, and God gave him the world to watch over. And the archbishops, they are shepherds of archdioceses. And then you have the bishops, they are shepherds of dioceses. And then we have the priests, they are shepherds of a parish. And you guys, like lay people, you are shepherds in your own family. And also you are shepherd of people God brought into your life. You are the shepherd, meaning that you have to watch over them. You know, if they do not come to church anymore, that's your job. God will be counting on you to bring that person back in church. So each one of us, we should have at least some people we watch over. You know, if something happened to them, or you know, if we don't see them anymore, we don't see them in church anymore, it's our job to find out what happened to them and to do the best we can, you know, to bring them back. So how do you know that you are a good shepherd? You are a good shepherd if what you allow in your life or in your family brings you close to God, or brings your family close to God. But if what you allow in your life or you allow in your family keeps you away from God, then you are a bad, you know, a bad shepherd. Jesus is our good shepherd. He's counting on us. We are small shepherds. He's counting on us, you know, to bring those who are falling away, to bring them back into the flock. Just like Jesus can leave 99 sheep to go to look for the one who is lost. So Jesus does not care only for those who are in the flock. He cares also for those who are lost. And go look for them, to find them, to bring them so that they can be with him. We have to be like Jesus, you know, to worry about those who are missing in church. Just like Jesus went for, leave behind the 99 to go to look for the lost one, we have to do the same thing also. We have to be able to look around to see who's missing in church, and then to let God use us so that we can bring them back. So may God bless you. May all of you be under God's holy protection. Amen. Let us proclaim our faith. I believe
Holy Spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us offer our petitions to God, the Almighty Father.
For the church, that we may be a living witness to the need for repentance, individually and collectively, always returning to the Good Shepherd who calls us each by name. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our nations at war and for all people affected by the violence, that leaders may find a way to bring justice and peace to their lands. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who respond to the voice of God, of the Good Shepherd, calling them to help shepherd the flock, for the ordained and lay vocations among God's people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have suffered physically, mentally, or emotional trauma, that they may find relief and comfort through the assistance of others. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have wandered off from the fold, that they may hear the voice of the Good Shepherd and be open to responding in hope and wonder. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear our prayers. We ask this through your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Beside restful waters, I am led. In the pasture plenty, my soul lies down. So come, all you thirsting, your soul shall be refreshed, and come all afflicted, and be healed. For though we walk in the darkness now, no evil shall we fear. If the light of his love be at our side, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Beside restful waters, I am led. In the pasture of plenty, my soul lies down. And come, all you hungry, at the table find his bread. And come now, be anointed, overflow with his goodness.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to our Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. At all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to Lord you, yet more gloriously, when Jesus, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light arise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are drawn open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has arisen. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. I humbly will pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Jesus, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Jesus Lopez, Elena Santos, George Flores Jr., Sylvia Rivas, Shirley Ann Flores, Arthur Flores, Valerie Aguijo, Rosendo G. Martinez, Dorothy Canales, Luis G. Leal, Robert G. Leal Sr., and Macrina Romero. I remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all of that in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God, the Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
For all those who are at home and cannot receive Jesus sacramentally, we offer this prayer, act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
The more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more your
I look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures. The sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Okay, so like I said, trusting Jesus doesn't mean that we don't use common sense. It doesn't mean that we have to bury our heads in the sand. It means only that you do whatever you can do. You do your part, and at some point, you will have to turn things over to God, because you have things only God can do, and you should trust Him to help you. Okay, so we come to the end of this Holy Mass. I want to say thank you now for all of you who are supporting the church. Thank you. I appreciate it. And may God continue to bless you. And also, we know that since they began to relax a little bit the law about the social distancing and putting on masks, they began to loosen it. But for us, we should continue to be prudent. Do whatever you can do to protect yourself and to protect others. I know that if we do our part, God also will do His part. You know, and at the end of the day, coronavirus will be defeated with God's help. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our mouth is ended, going in peace to love and serve the Lord.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkness night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkness night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good.
Okay, now I want to say thank you to Almaraz family, you know, Maria and Ottaviano and the family, because as we know, they are making face masks, and they are selling them and they're giving the money to the church. So I want to thank them for doing that and for giving the church this week more than $600. And that money, you know, is needed to pay our bills. And one more time, I want to say thanks to the Almaraz family. And may God bless you all. Amen.